On the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places. You break this time, Crowborn?
Nothing, Mr. Mushnick.
Oh, yeah, you didn't break anything, yeah. So she finally decides to come to work.
Good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that we've had a customer. Who has a customer when they run a flower shop on Skid Row? Sidor! What is going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, you better get back there and see what he's... Audrey, where'd you get that China?
China?
Audrey, that greasy boyfriend of yours, he's been beating on you again, hasn't he? Look, I know it's none of my business, but I'm beginning to think that he's maybe not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
I got this tightly potted for you, mister.
Whoa! Seymour! Look what you've done to the inventory!
Don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick. He's sensitive.
Hi, Audrey. You're looking radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I better clean these up before any of the customers get here.
Well, that ought to give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the streets, business is lousy, my life is a living hell. And you, urchins, off the stoop! It's bad enough I got the wines permanently decorating the storefront. I need 3 worthless ragamuffins to complete the picture.
Oh, we ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronan.
You wanna be in school?
Yeah, but we're on the split ship.
Right, we went to school to the 5th grade, then we split.
So, how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, when you from Skid Row, ain't no such thing.
Alarm goes off at 7, and you start up town. You put in your 8 hours for the powers that have always been.
Sing it, child,
till it's 5 p.m.
Downtown, where the folks are broke, you go downtown.
not.
I haven't been able to identify any of my books, so I gave my own name. I Call it an Audrey too.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, a strange, interesting plant like this, here in the window, well, maybe...
Maybe what? Do you know how any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in a window, people don't suddenly...
Excuse me. I couldn't help but notice that strange and interesting plant you have in the window. What is it?
It's an Audrey, too!
I haven't seen anything like it!
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple of weeks ago? I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day. And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man, he sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings. Cause, you see, strange plants are my hobby. He had nothing unusual there that day. So I was about to, just walk on by. When suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and there's this strange humming sound like something from another world. And when the light came back, this strange plant was just sitting there. Just stuck in, among the zinnias. I could have sworn I had been there before, but the old Chinese man stole it to me anyway. For $1.95.
Quite an unusual story and a fascinating one. Oh, come on, here, might as well take $50 worth of roses.
$50?
$50!
$50?
Yes, ma'am, right away.
Can you pick 100?
100? No. I'm afraid we closed the register for the day.
Well, I guess I'll just have to
get twice as much.
Twice as many? Twice as many!
Twice as many.
$100 worth of roses? Yes, ma'am, right away. Audrey, my darling, kindly bless this young lady our finest bunch of American red beauty roses.
Thank you very much. Yes, it is one quite strange and interesting plant you got there.
We did it.
Well, don't just stand there, but look at but that plant, what did you call it?
An Audrey too.
But that Audrey too in the window where the passers-by can see it. My God, I never believed it. My children, I'm taking us out to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Mystic, but I've got a date.
With the same no good Nick. I'm telling you, Audrey, you don't need a date with him. You need a major medical. He ain't a good, clean kind of boy.
Well, he's a professional.
What kind of professional drives a motorcycle and wears another jacket?
He's a rebel, Mr. Mushnick. He makes good money. And besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Have fun at dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Crowborn. You're staying right up here and taking care of that sick plant. How come it's always fading all the time?
I told you, I don't know. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Well, strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only you knew what breed it is, what genus, but it's nowhere in any of the books.
Well, Crowborn, my advice to you is you better figure it out and figure it out fast. Just look at this exotic little beauty has done for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse that plant back to health. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix. Good night.
Aw, Tui. I just don't know what else to do for ya. Mr. Mush, Nick, and Audrey. Well, they just met ya. But I've been going through this with ya for weeks. Grow and wilt. Spurt and flop. Are you sickly little plant, or are you just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunlight. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing.